Hi guys.
Hey everyone.
Welcome to Make 2 and a Sims FreePlay original design. Many thanks to EA for letting us have early access to the All Mezzed Up quest, which is one of the quests that was necessary to do this design. And you'll see why, because, well, you might have seen why already from the title of the video. I think we're going to call these like tiny loft houses or something, and you'll see why when we go in.
So we've been watching a ton of tiny house videos on YouTube recently, which I think was the inspiration for you saying, I'm going to make tiny houses my own. And I was like, no, I like where we live. And you're like, I'm just talking about Sims FreePlay. So
it is really tempting, though, when you watch these things. Like, there are basically like tours on YouTube of different tiny homes, you know, homes that are meant to be on as small of a footprint as possible. Usually off the grid, so that means like solar panels, they're not hooked into a city or a county or a state's electricity, and they've got like composting toilets, things like that, you know?
Yeah, basically, so, if you have no clothes and no books and no bags or toys or anything else.
No. The point of these tiny houses is to put in as many of the normal things that you would expect out of life into this kind of home. So you're going to see that reflected in these designs.
So we have a pair of tiny houses that you've been building.
Yeah, because why not?
Very rural lot.
Why not fit two on?
Because they're so tiny.
Exactly. So we have a truck here, and that is just a nod to the fact that most tiny homes are actually on wheels and can be pulled by truck to wherever. They're meant to be homes that you can take with you traveling around the country or something like that. So that's a nod to that. And then the fact that it's on this wizard cottage lot, which is unlocked by one of the wizard quests, is because a lot of these tiny houses are located on somebody else's land, and it's like out in the woods or on a mountain or in a field somewhere, really, just so that people can feel closer to nature. That's why we have a duck pond and people sitting by the campfire and also people sleeping outside.
How cute.
Obviously, they want to sleep inside their homes because the homes are built for that, but also they just want to be closer to nature, and so they have the option to sleep outside in these sleeping bags. All right, so we've got two styles of tiny home, and I'll go ahead and start with this one because I built this one first. This is meant to be more of a rustic kind of style.
Mm-hmm. I get that vibe.
Yeah. So a note about the exterior wood. A lot of the tiny homes in the tiny home movement are made, I think, out of like reclaimed items, like reclaimed wood, recycled wood.
They say cedar a lot.
Cedar a lot as well, natural type of materials. So that's why I went with the exterior wall and the roof that I did, so that you get that kind of rustic feeling.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of the tiny homes, as I said, they incorporate some of the everyday stuff that you would expect in a normal house. That's the whole point of it, is to pack in the stuff that still makes life comfortable. But
it's still a house. You're not living in a car.
Exactly. So as we go in, you see you have a fancy glass door.
Mm-hmm.
And again, a lot of tiny homes have lots of glass because being a small house, you want to have as much light from the outside. You want to have as many vistas as possible from the house so that it doesn't feel too small. All right, so all that introduction aside, let's go into the front door. And as you can see, this is the main living area. We've got a sim busy at work. I put in this wizard cottage stove with the wood because a lot of tiny homes have wood burning fireplaces, or not fireplace, but like wood burning stoves.
Yeah, stoves, these like super tiny ones, and you put a small piece of wood and it heats your house all night because your house is so small.
Exactly.
It doesn't take much to heat it. So
yeah,
it's pretty cool.
And there is just this one sofa here for sitting. I think I collected this from one of the pre-built templates for the penthouses. On this side, we've got the kitchen and dining area. So besides the oven, which was next to the stove, we've also got this table, which is technically from the backyard beautification event, that limited time event that is currently running at the time we're recording this video, but might have been finished already by the time the video publishes. But I like this because it fits all together with the corner counter and the refrigerator from the same event.
So
make it look like one smooth surface.
Seamless.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you got that waterfall almost edge to it as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I like what you put on top of the table here.
Yeah.
In tiny houses, everything, as much as it can be, is multifunctional.
Mm-hmm.
So here on one side, on the right-hand side, you've got some food items.
Yep.
And on the left-hand side, you have some books. So this is both going to be a dining table and also probably act as their office desk.
Yeah. And because it's seamless counter, it's workspace as well mm-hmm. for the kitchen. And here we've got a couple of herbs. Maybe they grew them out in their garden patch because they're living off the land to the extent possible. So then through this sliding door here, it's usually a pocket door in mm-hmm. these tiny houses.
That's what they all say, it's a pocket door.
To keep, or a barn door, basically just to keep space open and not too cluttered. So through that door, we've got the bathroom. And usually these bathrooms are pretty tightly squeezed in, although some people tend to want to put a full bathtub in their tiny homes, and I'm like, why?
I don't remember. I think I last had a bath 6 or 7 years ago.
What do you mean? Oh, like used a bath.
I have used a bath.
Yeah, yeah. Like had a proper sit-down bath.
I just use showers in a bath, or not in a bath, but showers rather than a bath.
So that's why there's only a small open shower here.
Yeah.
The toilet that I put here, I like to think that this is a composting toilet, which
it looks more like one than the other toilets in
exactly,
the game.
Yeah. And I think I'm using this one for that because you can see that it sits on a block above the floor a little bit, so a lot of composting toilets have that kind of setup to them. They're not like toilets with pipes. They're just kind of toilets sitting on top of a block.
Yeah, we don't know too much about it, and we don't research it too much.
Anyway, so this is the sink, and there is storage here. So with the tiny house, you want to make sure that every possible way that you can add storage is done. So there is space for this huge drawer and shelf unit, and that's, again, just a nod to the whole thing.
All your linens, all your toiletries, that kind of thing can go in there.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we had somebody working outside before we go there. What's he doing?
Oh. Well, somebody is grilling, somebody is gardening.
Outdoor cooking and gardening. There's a little cute rabbit.
Yes.
Hello.
And you'll probably notice that I've got this patio all around, and it's meant to be kind of like a deck. I know I said before that a lot of tiny houses are on wheels and are transportable, but also a lot of tiny houses are not, and they actually make use of huge decks around the house, again, to bring the people inside closer to nature, to get outside of the house and enjoy the outdoors.
I'm going to say those houses are placed somewhere where there aren't lots of mosquitoes, which
or,
is where we...
or they just take it, you know?
Yeah, they got very thick skin.
Okay, so behind this sliding door, which is directly opposite the one for the bathroom, is the water heater. Normally we see water heaters in tiny homes actually packed in very close to the kitchen and the bathroom, but this is the only place that I really could tuck it away, so I did that here. And then you have the ladder up to the next floor, which is meant to be a loft space. So this is where the All Mezzed Up quest comes in. The All Mezzed Up quest, which should be starting pretty soon, if not already, by the time we publish this video.
Yeah, April 2nd, April 3rd.
Yep. That is how you get the ability to build these lofts or mezzanines or indoor balconies. But basically, it's just a hole in the floor.
And why I think this is essential for making realistic-looking tiny houses, is tiny houses are on one floor only. This is on two floors, this building. Mm-hmm. But really, it would be on one and a half in reality.
Yep.
So you'd go up that ladder and you'd be on like a...
a loft space.
A loft space that's maybe only not enough space to stand up in, but enough space to crawl around in and definitely to lie down and sleep in.
You do see a lot of people trying to make tiny homes that are properly two stories that you can stand up in. I don't know about those. They seem less and less transportable the bigger, you know, you make them. But anyway, so yeah, this is the space where you come up from the ladder and kind of go along this catwalk here. There's a closet here, and then here's the sleeping space.
Very nice.
Yeah. And
loads of windows all the way around to give...
yes.
Lots of light and beautiful views.
We see that a lot in tiny homes as well, making sure that the living space, because it's so sort of cramped with a low ceiling, has lots of windows around so that you can, again, just look outside and escape the fact that you are living in a tiny home.
That is 3 by something. 3 by 10 or something.
Yeah. I mean, I definitely have seen other Sims Free players doing tiny homes, which are a lot smaller than this. But again, I just wanted to make this an inspired by the tiny home movement kind of thing and not like a challenge type of house. This is specifically inspired by tiny homes.
These aren't the smallest houses you can have, but these are very small and pack in a lot in a very small space.
Okay, so going to the second tiny home, this is actually meant to be a little more modern compared to the rustic one that we just toured. So that's why you see a lot of the windows are from the penthouse as well. And the stuff from the backyard beautification event, I went ahead and put some planters around as well because they're very modern looking. So let's see, the door is over here.
A double door.
Yeah.
So immediately you know it's going to be a bit more of a spacious mini home.
Yeah, I think a lot of tiny homes we've seen have double glass doors, and I just thought it'd be cool to have that as well, because that, again, gives the illusion that the house is not so small because you've got room for a double glass door. So here we have, in fact, a three-seater sofa. I think the other house only had a two-seater sofa, and they've got room for, here is one of those wood-burning stoves, which are so typical in tiny homes. And then over here is the kitchen. So this is sort of a galley-style kitchen, which means that there are counters on either side, but technically over here, this is not quite a counter, it's obviously just the table, but as you can see, they'd be able to use it as prep space, counter space, if they needed to. And we've got hanging pots here, just a nod to, again, trying to use as much space as efficiently as possible. And I put this coffee maker here because we've seen like a few tiny home owners with these like fancy drip coffee like setups. That's a nod to them. Okay, so then through this door here, we have the bathroom. And they just have room again for that composting toilet, sink, and a walk-in shower like this.
Very nice. And then we have the stairs.
Yeah.
Now, in most of these tiny homes, they make very good use of the space underneath the stairs. So I have tons of drawers or the stairs will lift up.
Yeah.
We obviously can't do that in this game, but we're going to pretend that that's how we structure. There's lots of storage space, lots of drawers and nooks and crannies under those stairs that the occupants can make use of.
Okay, here we are up in the loft space. And again, the mezzanine quest allows us to build that lofty hole in the floor like that so that you can overlook, and it gives the illusion with the staircase on this side of there being sort of like a catwalk between the two sleeping areas. As you can see on this end, there is a sleeping area for a child, and it's open, the doorway is open, and again, that's just because we've seen a lot of tiny homes like that.
We saw that one yesterday where they had a toddler's bedroom was literally underneath
the stairs,
the parents' bed.
Yeah, or something.
And it was like
closed off by a curtain or something like that.
And it wasn't like there was like a whole floor in between.
Yeah.
So like the toddler stands up and they'd be knocking their head against the floor of the parents' bed.
I mean, basically there is not really a lot of privacy, but you know, whatever. So this is the kid's bedroom, basically, or the kid's sleeping area. And they get a rug in this really cute style with the circles and lines as sort of a nod to like the fact that the kid would be using this as their play area as well sometimes. And then over here is the parents' sleeping space. And
I like this.
Yeah, and behind the headboard, again, just a nod to having to put in as much storage as possible wherever you can. You've got these storage cabinets behind the headboard of the bed here.
Lovely. Okay.
Scattered around, just, you know, they've got a lot of these tiny homeowners have pets, which, again, it's like, wow, how do you do it?
Didn't we see one with a mother and daughter, two cats and a dog?
Yeah, so.
And it was smaller than both of these. It's really impressive what people can do and what, you know, living a very minimal lifestyle as well, and also giving a good home for their children and pets.
So hopefully you guys have enjoyed this tour of our two tiny homes. Please let us know in the comments what you think. We definitely encourage you to search up on YouTube for some tiny home tours if you've never seen any before, because they are definitely pretty cool and they're tempting. Please let us know in the comments what you think, and if you are new to our channel, feel free to subscribe because we've got plenty more Sims FreePlay on the way.
Thanks for watching!